Nancy Ryder went missing on a dark night and was found dead the next morning on the abandoned railroad track. Her husband and lover were sitting in his chair looking at the flowers in the funeral home. The pink and white colors were so beautiful. As Oliver left, he looked down at the bricks, still thinking about his beautiful wife, Nancy. Months later, he was still looking for hints about what really happened. Oliver sat on the pavement crying. He would never find out the truth. The beach was often where Oliver would go when he was sad. It was the only place he could clear his mind. Maybe it was best we visited Nancy, so he did. He went to the cemetery where she was buried. Her tombstone said Bursley on it, which was her maiden name. Oliver paused for a moment. She was my wife, he thought. Why would they put her maiden name on her tombstone? He said it loud. Why? He said it louder. Because a thin, wispy, beautiful voice from behind him said, "You've been gone a long time. I just died, but you died long ago, and have been waiting all this time." Oliver turned around, looking at the woman who was once his wife, Nancy Ryder. The leaves on the fence rattled with the wind. "Nancy," he said. "Yes, it's me." Her voice sounded like airy music. "Welcome to heaven, Oliver. We are finally at peace together," she smiled. Oliver looked down, and there were cracks on the ground, leading up to the pathway of heaven to bricks. There was clear, beautiful blue water and bright pink flowers. He finally found Nancy.